Keep this going. Are you ready for your next act, ladies and gentlemen? Get it up for Emre Kose!
How's everyone doing? You all right? Yeah. So my girlfriend asked me why I decided to do this gig. And I said, I don't know, I guess I've got funny bones. She said, having a small dick doesn't count. She said, what, are you doing it for the attention? And I said, no, that's what the mustache is for. But don't worry, guys, honestly, the joke's on her because she doesn't even exist. So. I made her up. Has everyone had a good week? You had a good week? Yeah, I had a good week. I met John Cena this week. I don't know, yeah, give me a cheer if you're familiar with the works of John Cena. Yeah, for those of you who aren't, just ask yourselves, what if steroids had a face? Yeah, so basically, he's American, essentially, and whenever I come across anyone who's not English, I become like the most British person in the whole world. So I heard myself called WWE wrestler and Hollywood actor John Cena, old chap. Yeah, so I went up to him and I said, oh, you're right, old chap. I'm a really big fan of your work. Is there any chance I could get a photo? And he said, there's a great chance of that. Yeah, and I shook his hand, and I've never felt so safe. I think that's what love is. yeah. So my name's Emre. I'm half Irish and half Turkish. Merhaba. Which that was for them. Everyone else. Yeah. No, but yeah. Sorry. Learn Turkish. It's great. Which basically means I've got an Irish passport. Yeah. yeah. And now I'm going to tell you about it. No. And yeah. So means I've got an Irish passport, but I look like I know my way around a kebab. So yeah. My name means friend in Turkish. I thought it was quite sweet. So I asked my dad. I was like, Dad, you know, why would you name me friend? And he said, well, son, the Turkish word for all right once you get to know him was a bit too long. Bit too long. So yeah. So I thought I'd get him back. I said, all right then, Dad, what's the Turkish word for dickhead? And he said, that's your middle name. So. Yeah, yeah. I'm a teacher. Are there any teachers in? Always ask questions that you know you're going to get positive answers for. That's, yeah, no, you know what? I thought stand-up would be quite different from my day job as a teacher, but I had to think about it, and they're actually quite similar. I mean, ultimately, I'm standing up here, you're sitting down there. I'm going to waffle on for a bit, and, you know, if you don't like what I've got to say, then you can always throw your chair at me. So, yeah, and you know what? Actually, this happened to me in a lesson last week. This kid just, like, throws a chair at me. I teach drama as well, so there weren't even any chairs in the room. I don't know. Yeah. Yeah. I don't know. It, no, to be honest, it's my own fault. I taught them how to mime the week before, so. Yeah, no, the kids are, they are funny. Like, the thing is, right, I mean, the thing about teaching drama is that everyone says that drama teachers are just failed actors. And I... And I don't think that's very fair. I also sing, so yeah. But no, the kids, they are funny. Like, I don't know what your work weeks have been like, but I spent the first 20 minutes of my day last week consoling a boy in year 8 because he licked the floor. And he was upset because it didn't taste as good as last time. Yeah, like one of the first lessons I taught, you know, drama, I said, you're gonna do a scene, it can be about anything that you want. And this kid turns to his mate and he goes, psst, Jamal, we're gonna do a horror and it's about your hairline. I mean, I laughed, but obviously, like, not too loudly, because I didn't want to get roasted next, you know what I mean? I didn't need that on a Tuesday. I got heckled as well. I got heckled in a year seven lesson. I said, you're going to do some mime today. And this kid just shouts out from the back,